Hello guys. In today's lesson, we'll be discussing the different workspaces in Adobe Illustrator. So, what is a workspace? A workspace refers to the arrangement and layout of panels, tools, and interface elements within the application. It's a customizable setup that allows users to organize their tools and panels in a way that suits their preferences and workflow. Illustrator comes with several predefined workspaces such as Essentials, Essentials Classic, Printing, Improving, and the rest, each tailored to specific design tasks. You can find them under Window and then Workspace. I usually work with Essentials Classic Workspace because it offers all the basic panels and tools. You can choose the workspace that best fits your creative goal, and the panels that Illustrator thinks are the most useful will appear. In some workspaces, the toolbar will become streamlined, and many of the tools will not be visible. To make things look cleaner, the tools are moved to the Edit section at the bottom of the toolbar. Look for the three dots at the bottom of the toolbar. That is where all the other tools are hiding. Should you want one of the tools to be added to your toolbar, simply click and drag it to the toolbar. Some tools have a small arrow at the bottom right corner that signifies that those tools have more options. Click and hold, and the options will be revealed. Next to some of the options, you'll find letters, characters, and even combination of certain keys. They are the shortcut to pick those tools, so feel free to use them to enhance your workflow. When you choose a workspace, all the tools relevant to that workspace will be visible. At the top of the stack of tools is a small button with left arrows in it. When clicked, it expands the column so you can see more tools. Clicking it again collapses the tool panel to a single column. Okay, let's first change the workspace to Essential Classic, as we'll need a few panels to understand this. Much like with the toolbar, for the panels, click this button and it shall expand the panels. Clicking it again will retract them. You can also click and drag the panel out of its station to the free space and nest it back in. To get rid of a window, just click the small X button at the corner and it shall be gone. To get the window back, all you need to do is go to Window and you shall find that option sitting there. Simply click it and it shall be back on your screen. We can then drag it back to where it belongs. Suppose you're working on the Essentials Classic workspace. And while working on a task, you closed a few windows and added a few. Now you want the workspace to have the same panels back. So all you need to do is go back to Window and then Workspace and then click Reset Essentials Classic, since we were working on Essentials Classic. And it shall be back with its original settings. And this is good for all the other workspaces as well. You can adjust each panel's height by grabbing the bar along the bottom edge. Watch for the two-headed arrow, then drag the bar to resize the panels. Now let's say you want only certain panels to be in your workspace, because the task you're working on doesn't require most of the panels to be there on the screen. So let's remove a few panels from here. Okay, so I just want the layers panel to be there on my workspace. So what I'm going to do is go to Window and then Workspace and click New Workspace. Let's call it Personal and hit OK. This is now my personalized workspace, which will only have the layers panel on the right. Let's switch to some other workspace. Now, when I want to get back to my personal workspace, all I need to do is go to Window and then Workspace and select Personal from here. and my workspace settings with just the layers panel will be there. To remove your customized workspace, go to Window and then Workspace and select Manage Workspaces. In the pop-up screen, you'll only find the workspace you've made, so click it and then click the trash icon on the right and your workspace will be gone. And the default workspace essentials will be automatically selected. You can even create a new workspace from Manage Workspaces option by clicking the small plus button. Give your new workspace any name of your choice and hit OK. Now, when you go to Window and then Workspace, you shall find the new workspace sitting there with the same settings as the previously selected workspace, which was Essentials in our case. So guys, that's all about workspaces in Adobe Illustrator. All right, so we're going to stop here, and in the next lesson, we're going to explore artboards. After all, whatever we do in Illustrator is done on artboards, so ensure you don't miss the next one. Until then, goodbye, and thanks for watching.